Hello friends, this is Fortune Agro FAI 16 liters model disinfectant battery cum manual sprayer. This is very useful product for sanitizing and cleaning your warehouse, offices, parking lots, vehicles, staircase, etc. Now we will unbox the product and show you the installation procedure. It is very easy procedure and there is no tools at all required to install. It hardly takes 3 to 4 minutes to install, and after that I will show you the usage. Unbox the product, organize all the things, then I will show you one by one the installation procedure. While removing all the things from the disinfectant machine, just remove this cap. See what all products are, what all components are inside we have to remove. We have to remove it, all the components from inside. Once again we check, nothing is left inside. Now inside this machine at present only this pump is there. That's all. It is one of the best brand available with us, and it is an ISO certified company product which gives long durability and quality satisfaction. Procedure. Installation procedure. This is the battery cap. It is already inside. In case if it is loose, just have to push battery inside, insert it and lock it. We will start with this installation. This is a battery cum manual, which means it can work along with battery. Suppose in case the battery charge off goes off and some work is pending, it can work manual also. So we will start the installation. To check the installation, please see the steps carefully, and in case if you find any difficulty, rewind the video and see. These are the products which were there inside this machine. Now I will start the installation procedure. This is the handlebar rod which we have to install first. As you can see, there is one hole here. And in this handlebar rod, there is one hole here, you can see this hole. I am going to insert this hole inside here like this. And see at the reverse of the machine, remove this cap and just carefully, very carefully, you have to hold these wires like this so that this handle can be locked like this. Here, this is the hole. In this hole, from these products, you will find one pin like this. It is a half round pin. In center there is one round dot. I have to insert this pin inside, and which will lock this hole between these two yellow gaps. Now it is locked, so the handle cannot come out. After locking this, you just again close this gap to avoid dust getting inside and avoid getting it damaged. We'll make this rod like this. This rod is actually for manual working. Suppose when battery goes off or battery charge is off. Now we will take this rod. I will show you the installation for this rod. This smaller end you can see, and the bigger end. At both the ends there is one pinhole. So the smaller end, you have to insert it here, like this. And the bigger end should go like this. It should be in this position. make it up to this level. Before putting it, just check it, make this cap tight. Now it is tight, and we will make it to this level so that I can insert this rod here. In the accessories, I have two metal bushes. We have, this is the metal bush, just put this bush here. There is one metal cutter pin, we call, this is the pin, this cutter pin, insert it in the end and just bend one side up and one side down, so this get locked. Same procedure to be adopted at the bottom end. Here also I will put this cutter pin in the hole, make this one end top, one end down, so this is also got locked. Now it cannot be come out, it will not come out. We will just put this handle bush. Okay, and what you were seeing is the back portion. Now this is the front portion. For the time being, this is the nozzle. Take this cap out, tighten this cap here at this place, because this portion is to be used when you are using battery operation, this is to be used when you are using manual operation. Start. You will find one this regulator knob also. There is one knob, silver color knob. You have to put it here at this regulator pin. Put it tightly. This is the filter when water we are putting inside, so that water gets filtered. No problem even if you are using it or not. This will be inserted here. Since it is empty inside now, for the time being we will close the cap. This is the water passage pipe. There are both the ends are same. One end, tighten it at this place. Just see it does not get crisscross to avoid damages, and tighten it. No need to tighten with any tools, just tighten it with hands, that is more than enough. Carefully. Lever which we will press and water will flow, pressure lever. Just see that in this position, in this position, please clearly see the position very clearly. In this position we have to fit it, tighten it. Just see that everything don't get crisscross to avoid leakage. If any leakage happens, you have to reinstall like this. We have fitted it. This is the telescopic pipe. This end you will see. This end you have to tighten it here. Telescopic rod. Just tighten it carefully. Tighten it like this. Now it is tightened. What I mean by telescopic is, if you loose it like this here, the rod will come to extend the length as per your usage, like antenna. And then again retight this portion. Again tight this portion so that rod cannot come back. Means as per you use it, you will get familiar. It is better not to use the telescopic. You can use it at the maximum like this, or if you need full length. Now this rod is telescopic rod is installed. Now I will show you different type of sprayers available in this shower sprayer. This is one brass nozzle available. You can see one small hole clearly. If you use it this alone also, the water pressure will go up to 10 to 12 feet length with sharp pinpoint. Suppose this is very good for cleaning of doors, entry doors like that, where distance is high. Now let us change it. To change this nozzle, remove this nozzle from the top like this. See, not from the very top, just see there are two points and I am able to remove this top nozzle like this. See, this nozzle is removed. There is one washer already installed here, black color washer. So as per your choice, there is one multi spray which you can use at side walls and all. There is one more shower type sprayer for cleaning vehicles, your finished goods. One more shower type sprayer which you can just check putting all the types of sprayers and use it as per your choice. Here now I have shown you this type of nozzle for long distance and sharp pinpoint. You can install this multi one. This will give pressure from both the sides. Just put it and tighten it. Same type this one, you can put and tighten it. And the same type this one. So for the time being, let us just tighten one shower like this and leave it. These are the few accessories you can see here. These are the extra washer you can use for future use, which can be put here or at this place if there is any leakage. So later on you can use. This is one extra quarter pin. This is the washer extra. This is one extra washer which can be used here in this pump. When you loosen it, you will find one washer is already there. One is extra spare for later use. Just like the laptop bag, there is pin. I don't think much installation guidance is required for this. You can just try to install it anyhow, wherever required. So this can be like this, and this can be like this, so that the men can hang it on the back. The total weight will be hardly 15 kgs, so it won't be difficult. This, just after installing it, just check it that you have installed it tightly. Even if you are not using this, just handle it and use it. This is one measurement glass. Like if you are putting some Lysol, Dettol or phenol or any disinfectant solution inside with mixing water. Beta is me a rubber bush which will be used to hold these two rods so that it will not get shake when we are using the sprayer without battery purpose. But first off, if we are not using it with battery or the battery power goes off, what you have to do is remove this nozzle, remove this cap. Put this nozzle over here and put this cap back to this place. Whichever you are using, the other any one has to remain closed, otherwise water will get overflow. First let me just hand both the things. I'm just stiffing both the things here. Because of new piece might be little bit hard in the beginning. This I am not able to, little bit difficult. Anyway, means if it does not fit like this, you can just tie it somewhere, because mostly we will be using the battery operating function. So just try fitting it. We'll come to the next step. While just switch on, if I switch it on and there is a power indicator here, there is will light will come. Now I am switching on it. You can see this light is coming. And just touch the piece and vibration is there, the battery is working. And this is the regulator to increase or decrease the speed of the pressure. When you switch on the regulator, one small just fan like regulator, tuck sound will come.
you can increase the pressure speed. Let us keep it on the maximum speed. And now I will switch off the battery once again. The switch is off now. The light is still on. Regulator, if I am switching off, it is off. This is the charger in the off condition only. For the new piece, first charge your machine at least 6 to 8 hours in empty and switch off mode. After charging this for 8 hours, this is the procedure to charge. Just remove all the ties from the charger. This we are putting it. This is the place. Just check there is no water or anything going like this here. We'll put it like this and pluck it. Once you pluck it, there will be a light coming here and the charging will start. After 8 hours, you can see this indicator, the symptoms will change. And after 6 to 8 hours, just remove this charger. Remove this charger and make sure this cap is closed. Very first, the brass nozzle, keep it very safely in some box in your office for further usage. Keep all your washers, showers safely, the accessories. As I told in the beginning itself, when we are using battery operated procedure, this pipe has to be tightened here. When you are using manual operation, this has to be removed here, put in here, and remove the cap and put that cap here. Don't leave both the sides open. One side has to be, all both the sides to be remained closed. I will tell you the manual function also. Suppose in case in between some battery charge goes off and some work is remaining pending. This is the manual function. You will change the nozzle here, put this cap at the down, and then just while spraying, keep on pumping like this. And case spraying. After some pumping, if you put 5-6 time pumps, it continues spraying. Mostly, since it is battery operated, it is better to use with battery. And when charge goes off, if there is no sound or vibration, charge empty, recharge the battery once again for 2 hours time. In one full charge, you can fill the tank 6 to 7 times. Now, how to fill up the disinfectant with solution? Just remove the cap. This is the filter, if you want to use it or no problem. Put some disinfectant, like for outdoor use, sodium hydrochloride or some solution. For indoor use, you can put Lysol, Dettol, Phenyl. For car usage, you can use special car washers, car wash liquids, or even a normal hair shampoo. Don't use the bleach liquid upon your vehicles. Bleach liquid is only for floors. Okay. Till the full means just leave little bit empty. Till here it will absorb 15 liters of water. If you are mixing some solution, maybe little less of water. Till this level. After filling, close the tank. Now you can use it. Keep on changing the showers as per your usage. Start the spray like this. Since it is empty, you are not able to see the spray, but it is like this. In case when battery is running out and water is not coming, the tank gets very lightweight. Just switch it off and check whether the water is not over. If water is over, how can the water come? This is a common thing. Nothing to tell about it. So I'll tell you finally, this is the manual operation without battery. In this case, you have to change the cable. Now we are using only with battery because we have spent so much for the battery product. This is the rechargeable battery. When charge goes off, you have to again charge it. This is the rod. You have to keep on changing as per your choice. This washer, this nozzle,
This is the brass nozzle, smaller one for long distance. Now after the work is over, no need to dismantle anything, just clean the tank so that the disinfectant solution or any chemicals is there. Just clean the tank, leave the machine as it is, don't dismantle anything, just leave it aside carefully. That's all, friends. If any other doubt or queries, you can contact us. Keep always the charger clean, should not get wet, water touch should not come. At this point, be very careful while putting in charge, just check it, there is no water over here. In case, if there is no vibration, nothing, that means there is something mistake over here. Just see it is tightly fitted properly, otherwise once again remove it, push the battery little bit inside and this thing. This is the cushion type pad. While hanging it on your back, this will be more, this is for comfort usage. All the other accessories which I am putting back in cover. I am not sure for what purpose is this, we will make it useful later. Like this, this one cutter pin, these are few washers. I am just putting it all the things once again here. This is one thing to hang something somewhere, just a small issue, not a big thing. So these are the nozzles which I am keeping it. I am removing this nozzle once again back. Putting this nozzle once again. If I use this nozzle, the water will go up to the distance of 12 to 15 feet. What I'll do is I'll just fully close the telescopic rod so that it shall not get damaged. I've closed the rod and tightening it. Just leave the machine like this and the work is over almost. Nice product. This is a mini sprayer, 1.5 liter capacity for office use, small passages, office table, refrigerators, disinfecting of bikes. It will give small pressure like this. Just open this. Open the sprayer, you'll see this type. Fill it with water, normal phenol, Lysol, Dettol for sanitizing. Fill it up to the level, close it tightly. To spray, first then give a pressure like this 8 to 10 times to get you a full speed of pressure. After giving the pressure, this is for adjustment of speed and distance. Here if the distance is less, just rotate this knob. And if you want more or less distance, just rotate this now. This is the spray button. Press it. It is both lock type. If you want lock, there is a lock also that will continuously spray. See, the water is going on here. See, I'll show you the water distance. Water you can see. And we can just see this adjustment. This is we are calling mini magic. For office disinfectant sprayer.